This is my newest novel. It's right here. And it is a story that takes place in a world where some people called prodigies have superpowers. And in this world, they've divided into two factions. There's the renegades, who are kind of your typical superheroes. They're trying to fight for justice and defend the weak. Alternatively, there are the anarchists, who are your kind of supervillains. And they are trying to return the world to a state of anarchy, and they believe in personal freedom and believe that the renegades have too much control. From these two factions, we meet a girl named Nova, who has been raised by the anarchists, and she is very resentful against the renegades because she believes that they failed to come to her family's rescue when she was a child. Then we also meet a boy named Adrian, who has been raised by renegades. And so these two characters, they meet and they start to develop romantic feelings for each other, not knowing their secret alter egos, who, as the story develops, kind of come to realize that they are actually arch enemies. That's definitely one of the things I was trying to play with in the course of this story, is that you do start out with the good guys and the bad guys. And definitely the renegades do have good intentions and try to be heroic, but it doesn't always work out how they want it to. And sometimes, you know, do the ends always justify the means is a question that comes up a lot. And alternatively, with the anarchists, just because they sometimes use awful ways of trying to get what they want doesn't necessarily mean that what they want is always bad. And so there's a lot of gray areas in between good and evil, hero and villain, and that's definitely something that I tried to play on and draw out from the characters, and that I hope readers will read it and find themselves questioning sometimes what is good and what is bad. I was definitely very inspired by classic comics, both DC and Marvel, and even like some of the superhero stories from like anime. I watched a lot of Japanese anime as a kid, so there were a lot of influences coming into the writing of Renegades. And one of my goals in writing this book was that I wanted it to feel familiar to people who are fans of classic comics. I wanted it to feel like that they could pick up on some of those references of, oh, this is kind of the Batman character, and oh, this is inspired by X-Men, and I wanted them to feel like it could fit into the same world while still, you know, of course, giving my own spin to it. It was really difficult to try to come up with superpowers that haven't been done by DC and Marvel. They, of course, have such a huge, elaborate universe. And that was one of the biggest troubles that I found myself running into as I was writing this book, was that I would get an idea for a superpower that to me seemed really cool and unique. And then I would look it up and find, oh no, there's already a Marvel character with that. Oh no, there's someone in DC who does that. And so it was really difficult to find superpowers that were 100% unique. But I did, even when I was using a superpower that maybe had been done before, I would still try to give my own unique twist to it, make it maybe used a little differently, or try to find ways to connect it to the characters in a different way, so that I hope it still reads like its own original idea. I would love my book to be adapted to film. It has not yet sold to Hollywood Studio, but I would love to see that. I would love to see any of my books made into movies. And in particular with Renegades, you know, obviously I was very influenced by a lot of superhero movies. I love watching superhero movies. And when I was writing this book, I very much felt in a lot of times that I was almost seeing a movie in my imagination and then just trying to translate what I was seeing onto the page. And so, yeah, I would love it. We'll see. Fingers crossed.